Welcome to This Is My Architecture. I'm Matt from AWS. Today I'm joined by Abhishek from Vizio. Thanks for joining.
Thanks, Matt.
So tell us about Vizio.
Vizio is one of the largest TV and soundbar makers in America. And we focus, our focus is on making the smart TVs and bringing, you know, a better experience for our customers.
Great. So these TVs are not the TVs that our parents had. They're smart, like you said. They have a lot of data, a lot of telemetry. So I see we have a TV over here. Tell us about how you're using that TV data with AWS.
So TVs do generate a lot of data for us, and that data, you know, could be logs.
Yeah.
Right? And we do post a lot of performance telemetry.
Sure.
For, and, you know, whatever, you know, is happening on the TV.
Mm-hmm.
And then there is also some user data where we do want to know how our application is being used to bring, you know, even better experience for our users.
Yeah, sure. So you can do better things for customers with this data. So the raw data doesn't tell you much. You have to process it, ingest it.
Yep.
So I see you have Kinesis. Is that kind of your front door to the cloud?
It is true. The Kinesis data streams are our front door, and everything is being piped through Kinesis. And we do run an 8-shard Kinesis pipeline, which we have not yet, you know, needed to scale it up.
Okay, so these TVs are talking directly to Kinesis to ingest or to send their data up to the cloud?
Yeah.
And you could, but you haven't had to scale the Kinesis by adding or removing shards?
Not yet, no.
Okay, yeah. Great. So data gets to Kinesis from the TVs, different streams, I imagine, different types of data, logs, performance, user. Do these have different characteristics? Are they in different formats?
They are all different formats and different columns, if you will.
Yeah.
And the best part here is that we are not sticking to any particular schema yet. So we are free to send anything we want in any format,
mm-hmm.
and then we will pipe it through Firehose. Kinesis Firehose takes the data as is and dumps it into Redshift.
So you're using Redshift as a data warehouse. So you collect the data, it goes through Kinesis, you use Firehose to ingest it into mm-hmm. Redshift. I see S3 down here. Does that mean you're using Redshift Spectrum, or how are you using S3?
S3 is just our data store, and data is cheap, so we just keep it there forever for future use. We do not necessarily import all the columns we send out here to Redshift.
Okay, so the raw data sort of finds its long-term home in S3,
yeah.
and then a subset of that gets ingested into the data warehouse.
That is correct.
Okay, have you always used Redshift, or have you experimented with different types of databases?
We did start experimenting with AWS Aurora.
Yeah.
And we figured out that, you know, billions of rows, you know, that do not aggregate well in Aurora, and that was just not the right use case for it.
Okay, yeah, I mean, that's why we have different types of data stores and databases in AWS for different purposes, and certainly for, you know, the scale maybe you're talking with all the TVs out there. How much are you talking? What kind of scale are we talking about?
We are talking about millions of connected devices mm-hmm. and billions of events per month.
Okay, so billions of events per month that you want to aggregate.
Yeah.
Yeah, it's definitely an analytics use case, great case for Redshift. So the data, I understand so far you're persistent in S3 long-term. I guess you could reload it if you know you ever need to replace the database or data warehouse.
That is true, and we did that when we experimented with Aurora.
Yeah.
We had to quickly migrate to using Redshift, and mm-hmm. at that time we had everything in S3 and in the data streams. We were able to just reload everything in Redshift without any data loss.
Okay, and then how do you actually visualize the data? How do your users make use of it?
For that, we use Amazon QuickSight.
Mm-hmm.
And QuickSight is a great tool for visualizing, you know, aggregation. And we do use the inbuilt in-memory database called Spice,
yeah.
Where we write custom SQL or custom queries to download the data from Redshift to the Spice data sets, from where, you know, it's snappy. It's very snappy to create, you know, slice and dice the data and create the reports you want.
Great. So you take subsets of data using custom SQL, you put it into the in-memory Spice database for QuickSight so your users can visualize it quickly and generate the reports.
Yeah.
Okay, that's very cool. I love, you know, the scale that you're operating at. How long did it take you to build this whole thing?
So we started this project with Amazon Professional Services help.
Yeah.
And I think within a few weeks span, we had the first prototype, and we were like fifth week, we were in the production.
Wow.
So from zero to users being able to use QuickSight and run reports on it, this was like maybe 6 weeks.
It's great to hear you're having success with professional services in like 6 weeks to
That's
production
true.
For an analytics, you know, where we're talking billions of messages is pretty amazing.
It is pretty amazing, yeah.
Yeah.
And Redshift, by the nature of it, it is great with running large aggregation because it fetches columns. So the I/O is very optimized, and mm-hmm. we could see the results right away in the throughput.
Absolutely, the benefits of a columnar database like Redshift for
large-scale
analytics. Very cool to see. Well, I like it. It's sort of an elegant solution to a scale problem to make use of all of this data that our smart TVs are able to produce these days. Thanks for sharing with us. It's very interesting.
Thanks, Matt.
And thanks for watching. This is My Architecture.